Hello everyone, a very good morning to all of you students. This is Assistant Professor Ishani Trivedi from LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology, continuing with the session of the subject Construction Equipment and Automation. Now students, you saw that in the previous session we started discussing about the new concept regarding the surveying works, right? The automation in the surveying works. First of all, we had to discuss about the various concepts regarding the same, that how the surveying work is carried out when you are dealing with the locations, with the situations where terrestrial is not possible, where you cannot carry out the survey works completely from the ground. Then in that case, you will have to use different equipment and different technologies to cover the whole area and carry out the survey works. Not just the survey works, we can use it in plenty of applications we have. So we discussed about the concept regarding the survey work which is to be carried out, in which we are going to apply the automation, that is the photogrammetry. We discussed the various basic concepts regarding what are the different types of photogrammetry which can be done. Out of that, the most important for us is the aerial photogrammetry. Now students, you are already familiar what is photogrammetry, how the work is performed, and how different aircrafts are used to carry out the survey of the place. And I had also mentioned that specifically once we are done with understanding the aerial photogrammetry, we are going to talk about how drones can be applied in the photogrammetry. Now today we are going to talk about with what equipment this aerial photogrammetry is conducted. So we know that it is to be done with the help of taking photographs, then merging the photographs, processing the photographs, reducing it to make the topographical maps, which is the basic process of the photogrammetry. So now today we are going to talk about the equipment which will be mounted on the aircraft or on the drone, whichever type of equipment you are using, that is the aerial camera. What are we going to call it? Not just camera, we are going to call it aerial camera. Now see students, it is important to understand that it is nothing but the regular routine camera, but here the resolution, right, the resolution will be very much high. The speed will be very much high, the lens will be of very high quality. I can say that around in fraction of seconds it is going to take photographs. Around 100 to thousands photographs can be taken in just a time period of 1 second. So this will be the accuracy and the quality of the aerial camera which is used for the survey purpose. Now let us first try to understand what is an aerial camera. Then moving on, we are going to talk about how it is mounted and how it can be used. So first, what is aerial camera? Now I am flashing my cursor over here. We can see that this is your example of a camera. It is a small compact camera. You can compare it to a DSLR as well. It is just a digital camera. At the bottom we can see that it is mounted in a drone. Similarly, you can see that here it is mounted on the aircraft, right? For the standardized aerial photogrammetry, aircrafts are always used. Nowadays, in the new technology, in the automation part, drones are also used. You can consider it as a robotics as well. So here we can see these are the various types of aerial camera in front of you. Let us talk about this. The function of the terrestrial camera as well as the aerial camera is same. This is going to be obvious if you are using the camera on the ground or if you are using in mid-air. For the aerial photogrammetry, then both of them are going to have the same purpose, that is taking the photographs. Since the aerial camera is mounted on a fast moving aircraft, its requirements are different. For the ground, for the terrestrial camera, the requirements will not be as such critical. You can do it just with the help of the tripod stand or any kind of survey equipment. But in the aerial camera, since it is mounted on the fast moving aircraft or a drone, its requirement will be different. I think it is to be understood. So it says, what does it require? Since you are taking photographs from the aircraft which is moving fast, as I said, the speed will be also very large. Around hundreds to thousands photos can be clicked in just one go. So it says high speed and efficient shutter. Now we are talking about the camera shutter, right? The shutter which closes and opens while taking the photograph, that is the camera shutter. So it requires high speed and efficient camera shutter. Next, fast lens, right, to take the photograph. Now if I say that within fraction of seconds one photograph will be taken, it means the lens of the camera has to be very fast and it has to be very high resolution as well. The third requirement is high speed immersion for the film. Now the photographs will be taken on the film. Here the camera will not be digitally giving you images. If you want the digital images, if you want to directly convert it to 3D models and mapping, then it will become your automation, which can be done in the drones. But here the requirement is high speed immersion. The film, the type of the film which we are talking, the standard film which is mounted in the camera which is present, that is your high speed immersion film. Next, a magazine to hold large rolls, right? The number of photographs taken will be very large, so you are going to require the roll which will be having a magazine to hold large rolls. Now about all these parts, we are going to discuss about the same in the next. As I said, that we are going to talk about the various parts of the aerial camera. Today we are only going to discuss about the aerial camera which has to be used. So what are the parts that we have? Now see students, you should note that in the traditional times, in the old times, the camera which was used was very large in size. I am showing you the traditional camera over here. It is even larger. If you search for the references, then you will find out that the camera was of very large size, the standard traditional camera. At the bottom you can see is the terrestrial camera, where you can carry out the work on the ground itself. You are going to have a screen attached with it so that you can process the models on the site, the photographs on the site as well. So what are the various parts which we have? What are the parts of a standard aerial camera which has to be studied? So the first is the lens assembly, right? The camera lens, it will be assembly consisting of the lens, the diaphragm, shutter and filter, right? So these are the basic parts of a camera. I think you should have heard somewhere or the other what are the different parts of camera. Here nothing new is happening over here. The next is camera cone. The third is focal plane. Next is camera body, that is its outer body. The fifth is drive mechanism and the last is the magazine. We used the word magazine in the last discussion, that was requirement of the aerial camera. Now in the image which is over here, this is a simple photograph not showing all the details of the parts of the camera. We have the rolls over here. One is take up and one is the feeder, that is your rolls or the reels. Then we have the focal plane. At the bottom we have the lens. In between the lens we have the shutter that is going to open and close while taking photographs. And at the front we have the filter. Now see, I can say that this part is your lens assembly. It is having lens, it is having shutter and filter. We will also see where the diaphragm is located. This is your lens assembly. Now let us talk about the various parts and with cross-sectional image in detail. Also mark students that you are supposed to draw this sketch if it is asked in your descriptive exams. So this is important. So let us discuss about the parts of the aerial camera. What do we have first? We have the first one is lens. Now as I said, very high quality lens will be required. The type of the lens will be compound lens. They are used in the aerial camera. Various lenses are available. You can find out about the same. The accuracy of the work depends on the quality of the lens. I think that factor is to be understood. Now, what does the lens do? What is the main function of the lens? We know that there is always a lens fixed in camera. We also have a lens fixed in our eyes. Eyes are nothing but one type of camera itself. The functioning, the working is kind of the same. So what does the lens do? The lens gathers the light. The lens gathers the light from the object and brings them to the focus in the focal plane. So the lens is going to gather the light from the object and it will bring it to the focal plane of the camera, of the focus, which is going to help it capture the image. Second which we have is filter. Now let us have a look, where is the lens? First of all, we can see over here, this is your camera lens. It should be visible to you if you hold a camera as well. The next which we have is filter. Now I am highlighting the filter over here. We can see what does it say? It says that the filter is placed in front of the lens, which we can see right in front of us. I have highlighted the same. So what is the work of the filter? Right, the filter protects the lens from the dust. Then it reduces the effect of atmospheric haze, that is the faded images. If it captures faded images, it means then it is having effect of the haze. Haze is a particular atmospheric effect which is going to affect the clarity. Next, it provides uniform light distribution over the format. So these are the basic functions of the filter. The third which we have is shutter. Now what does the work of the shutter do? I am highlighting over here the shutter, we can see. So it controls the exposure time during which the light is permitted to pass through the lens. So it controls the exposure time, right? The shutter is going to open wide and get closed. So for that purpose, the shutter controls the time, exposure time during which the light is permitted inside the camera, and then the lens is going to capture the image. Now shutters are generally of two types. You just have to remember about this. If we go in very much depth, then we will be diverting from our topic. So the shutters are of two types: between the lens shutter and focal plane shutters. Its locations will be different, nothing else. So in the aerial camera, between the lens shutter type is used when we are talking about the same. Now the next which we are going to discuss is about the diaphragm. So please students, note that currently we are talking about the lens assembly itself. We saw that the lens assembly comprises of the filter, the shutter, the lens, and the fourth one, which is diaphragm. Now more or less all of the members have the same purposes. Let us see what is the work of the diaphragm. The diaphragm says it controls the amount of light which is permitted to pass through the lens. Now the lens, the purpose of the lens is to capture the images. The filter is preventing the dust to enter. The shutter is preventing the amount of exposure or to light to be done. Similarly, diaphragm is the one which controls the amount of light which is permitted to pass through the lens and then capture the image. So this together, all four things comprises of the lens assembly. Its purposes are important to remember, and you will be able to correlate it as well. So the size of the diaphragm varies as per the aperture. Now the aperture means the opening, right? The shutter is going to open and close. So based on the opening is the size of the diaphragm. For normal 6 inches focal length camera, the size of the diaphragm varies from 7 mm to 38 mm. It depends on what type of focal length camera you are using. So it is important to note that the camera is also designed based on the focal length. Now, next which we are going to talk about is the camera cone. What is camera cone? It supports the entire lens assembly. I am highlighting over here. You can see this is the camera cone. The first was the lens assembly, and in the lens assembly we discussed about the all four members. Then we have the camera cone. So the camera cone is the body which supports your full lens assembly. So at the top of it are provided the collimation marks which define the focal plane of the camera. So a kind of marks are given on the top of the camera cone by which you will be able to judge that what is the focal plane of the camera. Now focal plane, focal length, that is the distance between the focal plane and the lens. All of these things are basic concepts regarding the lens. I think you should be knowing about convex lens and concave lens and the focal length, about the reflected rays which you used to study. So all these concepts are nothing but the same. Next we have is the focal plane. What is a focal plane? The collimation marks I discussed in the camera cone, that the collimation marks define the focal plane of the camera. They will be given at the upper surface of the camera cone. So the focal plane is provided exactly above the collimation marks, right? Above the collimation marks, we have the focal plane. We can see it is highlighted in front of us, and the distance will be your focal length. And you cannot actually change the focal length and the focal plane. Its distance will be fixed. And based on that, what quality of photograph you are achieving, it will be depending on that as well. So we have is, it is kept in such a way that the best possible image is obtained, which I said to you already. So that is your focal plane, and you can also define the focal length. Next, which we are going to talk about the part is the camera body. See, we are progressing one by one. We started from the front. We are going towards the rear end. So we have the camera body. So the camera body houses the drive mechanism. Now, what is the drive mechanism? We can see over here it has a trunnion. So how does it work? So the drive mechanism means the camera's drive mechanism internally, which is going to provide with purposes like flattening the film, because when the reel will be coming from over here, it has to be flattened because it is a roll. So it is flattening the film, it is advancing the film, it is tripping the shutter, meaning the amount of time the shutter is required to open and get closed. So this is monitored with the help of the drive mechanism, and this drive mechanism is covered in the body, in the casing, that is known as camera body. So how does it work? It is usually one piece casting, and electric motor provides the power for the drive mechanism to work, because some operation has to be provided here so that this purposes can be fulfilled. And the last which we have is magazine. Camera magazine holds the film. Now we can see over here we have two films. This so happens that when we are taking aerial photograph, it will be in number of hundreds or thousands. So if the reel or the film gets over, then you have to give provision of two films. So as soon as the first one gets over, the second will start rolling. So what will be the length of such rolls? It is around 60 meter to 120 meter. This is how your film or reels are attached, and the body which is housing the same is known as magazine. Okay, students, this covers your all of the parts of the aerial camera. I suppose you are going to remember them, because without remembering them, you will not be able to understand the further concepts. So I suggest that you go through them thoroughly. Okay, students, we will meet in next session. Have a good day. Thank you.